Hey, what's up guys, it's Iborn Seller, and today I'll be doing a commentary on this gameplay video that I did a few hours ago, as well as talk about the most recent Battlefield 3 news, and in addition to that, also do a quick giveaway for a Dr. Pepper code, which I have 5 of them, so I'll be giving one away throughout the week, so if you don't win this time, you might get lucky the next time, so. Yeah, don't lose hope, I guess, because I guess if you don't know what these codes can get you, it's one of 5 dog tags or a multiplayer camouflage. And I guess I'll just get down to the giveaway right off the bat, because some of you, want to know about that only, I guess. So in order to be eligible to, enter to the contest, all you have to do is answer the following question, which is... which weapon from previous Battlefield titles or any other game would you like to see added to Battlefield 3? And all you have to do is just leave your answer to that question in the comment section, and I will choose a winner tomorrow at around 6 p.m. Eastern time. So once again, answer this question, which is: which weapon from previous Battlefield titles or any other game would you like to see added to Battlefield 3? And leave your answer in the comment section, and I will choose a random winner tomorrow at around 6 p.m. Eastern time. So that's that, I guess. So let's get down to the news, which there are quite a bit of. So the first one is a Battlefield 3 community manager out for NW3s, CMs, dog tags, balancing PDWs, and more patch details. So recently in a podcast with Don't Revive Me Bro, global community manager Daniel Zintho, or Zinto, I guess, Matros revealed his intent to follow through on a challenge provided by Modern Warfare 3's creative strategist Robert FourZeroTwo Bowling during GamesCon 2011. And the challenge was to obtain each other's dog tags in a match in Battlefield 3. So, I guess they're going to be doing that, but, not really a new story, just, a quick thing that wasn't a new story, so, I just said it anyway. But, the next one is, about patches. So, fans have, stated that they prefer smaller patches that are released more often, as opposed to large patches released at a slower pace, which, I really agree with that, because I like, quicker, smaller patches to be made on the fly. So, and senior gameplay designer Alan Kertz said, "You can't do that on the Xbox and PS3. It takes weeks to get the patch through certification. PC is different; needs more tests." So, I guess the answer is no. But I wish, at least for us PC players, we could get those patches a little bit quicker. That would be great. But yes, too bad if they can't. So, moving on to the PDWs, or personal defense weapons, and the quote reads: "PDWs are an interesting balanced trial between hardcore and normal. They're quite good on hardcore, but rather weak in normal. And I guess that's because their firing rate is really high in regular multiplayer. Fire rate doesn't, automatically mean a instant kill, but in hardcore it definitely means, an instant kill. So I guess they might be making them a little bit better for regular multiplayer, perhaps. But who knows? So moving on to the next news story, which is Battlefield 3 sells 2 million copies in October in the U.S. And the quote says, or the news story rather, says, according to NPD, Battlefield 3 sold just under 2 million copies in the United States for the month of October. The 2 million numbers may not sound impressive compared to EA's figures of 5 million sold and 10 million shipped, but remember the NPD only tracks data in the US, and that Battlefield 3 was launched in late October with less than a week on the shelves. And I guess that's a pretty good number. And once again, the 360 led the sales numbers. So, PC kinda got less, you know, sales, but you know, it's still sold enough for me to be able to play with a lot of people, so. And I guess moving on to the next news story, which is about drivers for NVIDIA. So, like I said, maybe I think 2 days ago, NVIDIA and ATI, or AMD rather, are coming out with new drivers, and NVIDIA are giving a little bit more details of what these drivers will do. So the two 85.79 beta drivers will include, one, fixes cases of irregular performance, stuttering, primarily seen on DirectX 10 GPUs. The fix improves the performance of both DX10 and DX11 GPUs. 2. Fixes shadow map corruption seen with DirectX 10 GPUs. And 3. Fixes cases of black corruption between lines, triangles, with DirectX 10 GPUs. So, if you have a NVIDIA card, you should download these drivers and install them right away, because even though they're beta drivers, NVIDIA still recommends all Battlefield 3 players to install them and, you know, use them. So, but moving on to that's the last news story, which is about Kmart Battlefield 3 deals. So yesterday I talked about a lot of Battlefield 3 deals are happening in Black Friday, but I didn't have any for Kmart, so I guess they surfaced today, which are just for Battlefield 3. Battlefield 3 will be sold for $35 on Friday. You know, Friday's Doorbuster sale for 360 and PS3. No mention of a PC version, so I guess if you're looking to get Battlefield 3 for other console, then Kmart will be a good place to get it. Although I think, if I remember correctly, Walmart still had the better deal. Oh yeah, Walmart, Battlefield 3, $28, so, you know, $7 less there, so I guess, you know, Walmart still has the better deal, so if you want to get Battlefield 3, I guess you should get it from Walmart. If you want it for, you know, either of the console versions. And I guess that wasn't the last news story, still got one more, which is not really related to Battlefield, but rather EA and Origin. So it says EA wants to bring Origin to the Wii U, and Valve might also be interested. So according to a rumor, Valve are also trying to bring Steam to Nintendo's latest console, but EA are, quote, aggressively persuading Nintendo to go Origin's exclusive with Wii U's online so they can gain a competitive advantage over Steam. So again, I'm only talking about this because it relates to Origin, and you know, Battlefield 3 relies on Origin, so I guess you can deduce that at some point a Battlefield title might come to the Wii U. So, you know, if you are maybe you're thinking of getting a Wii U, which I'm still kind of, I don't want to say on the fence, because I'm not really thinking about getting that console. I didn't get a Wii, so I mean, I don't see a point of getting a Wii U. I mean, I pretty much played all those Mario titles before, so I don't really want to play any more of them, at least for a while. So, but anyway, you know, Wii U, Origin might be coming to him, so that means probably Battlefield 3 or future Battlefield titles might come to it. And right here, I kind of get glitched in there for a second, so that was kind of weird. But yeah, that's pretty much all I got for you guys today as far as news stories go. And I guess real quick, today I made my second video for the game, or the Modern Game Studio channel, and it was the Engineer Class Guide. And if you guys remember, I made the original video was around almost 30 minutes long, and I was able to, I don't want to say cram, but put all the information that was in that long video into just 12 minutes. So I was kind of proud of myself that I was able to, you know, put all the tips that I gave you guys in the 30-minute version just down to, you know, condense it down to 12 minutes. So I'll leave an annotation somewhere on the video right now to let you guys know, you know, if you didn't like the long version, you can just watch the shorter version and get all the information that I gave you guys already. So you know, if you didn't watch all those 30 minutes of me talking about the engineer class. So, and, you know, like I said yesterday, I made the assault class, guys. So, and, like, again, if you didn't want to watch the long version, you can watch the more condensed version, which, again, tells you everything that you need to know about the assault class. So check those two videos out. And, of course, you know, check their channel out, because they're a pretty cool channel. I mean, they have they're starting out as a channel that primarily focuses on educational videos, you know, as in, you know, videos that might make you better at a certain game. You know, in my case, I'm uploading videos about Battlefield 3, so my videos might help you, you know, become a better player. You know, as of right now, I only have the assault class guide and the engineer class guide, and once I make the support class guide, which is right on track to come out next week, I think I'm around 10,000 XP from getting the M60, so once I play with that weapon a little bit, I'll be able to play my support class guide, and you know, look for that next week, and I'll probably upload a shorter version to the Modern Games Studio. So, you know, if you don't want to watch the, I don't know how long it's gonna be, maybe 20 minutes long, then, you know, watch the Modern Games Studio's video instead, you know, if you want just, you know, a quicker version of everything that I'll be talking about. So, and, you know, again, the recon class, still a long way to go from happening, so, and right there, just real quick, picking up a ammo box to, you know, refill ammo, because I kind of had to do that because I ran out of ammo. So, you know, always quick thinking support class guys, you know, don't want to give you ammo, then look around, you know, and find a dead body, you know, of a support class, and, you know, pick it up and get some ammo. So that's what I just did there. So, you know, that's good thinking. So, and, you know, that can work for any other class. I mean, if you see a body dead, and by that, a buddy, you know, one of your buddies, and, you know, there's a medic around, you know, get his kit and revive him. Because, I mean, that one, you know, ticket that you gain back, it might not, you know, help you in the long run, but it just might, you know, you never know. So, you know, so do that all the time, you know, we switch kits if you should. So, but anyways, I guess I'll just talk about the gameplay itself right now. I pretty much talk about everything that I had. So right now I am playing in Pedestrian Border Conquest, and I am using the G36C with the M145 optical scope, the foregrip, and I think the laser sight. And I end up going, I think 17 kills and like maybe 6 deaths, I think, or something like that. And it was a pretty good match, because we won by, not a whole lot, but you know, we won by quite a bit. So, and right there I got killed by another G36 user, which is probably the only way that I could have been killed by. So I'm 15-3 at the moment. So. And let's see, I think I spawn on D again, because always spawning on D or C is a good idea, because people are always tend to be around those two areas, I think, or it's you know, it's the middle of the map, so that's where the most you know, quote unquote traffic occurs. So, you know, that's where all the action is at most of the time. So that's where I like to spawn, or close to a teammate that might be close to the action. So. Of course, right there. I thought that this tank was there was somebody inside, you know, a friendly, but there was an enemy in there. So I tried to damage it, and I realized that I think that guy jumped out, so I was gonna get in it, but I think this guy killed me. So that was a bit of a bummer, because I didn't get to steal his vehicle. So, but let's see, where are my teammates? I think I spawned on one of these guys, or never mind, I just spawned right back on D. So. And I think I'm using just the rocket, the RPG, so. And I think right here, I think the game just ends. We're going 85 to 12, and that counter just drops down like a fly really quickly, so. The game was pretty much over at this point. Man, there was pretty much nothing else they could do, because Once a team gains the lead by around, say, 50 kills, then the game is pretty much decided right then and there, so... But, yeah, I mean, 8-1, so right there we just won, so... GG at the end, you know, always say good game, because, you know, it shows a good sportsmanship, so... 17-5, you know, pretty good score, 3100 XP, I think fourth on my team, so... Very good, I leveled up to level 35, so that was cool. But anyway, guys, that's all I got for you guys today as far as this commentary goes. And if you guys could comment on the video, rate it, and subscribe to my channel, that'd be great. And, you know, also subscribe to the Modern Game Studios channel and check out their stuff and my stuff there. So I guess I will see you guys later. Once again, you know, leave your comment for the Dr. Pepper giveaway. So later.